Hello, my name is Scott Shepherd, and I teach in the Electrical Engineering Technology Department. Typically, the electronics side is dealing with lower voltage stuff, so stuff in your electronics like your computers, your cell phones, your laptop, different communications type stuff. Whereas the electrical side is looking at higher voltages of 120 volts, which is your outlet voltage at your house, up to 735,000 volts, which is high voltage power line transmission lines. So anyone that has to work with electricity needs to know some very basic stuff. So electrical and electronics, those first two semesters are common between electronics and electrical engineering technology for that reason. And then at that point, we diversify into more specialized courses for those two different programs.
Electrical engineering, I took up this same course in Philippines, and also I like electricity, like high voltage. Electrical stood out when I choose the specialization, especially the distribution, because I like to work on, you have three choices of work after you graduate. You can go on utility, you can go on commercial, and then you can do also like residential, like a contracting company. So, and then I really like to work on high voltage.
I think part of the electrical side is I do have a definite interest in motors and in solar energy and wind energy, renewable energy technologies. And though there is an electronics component to those, the distribution side of those alternative energies are a little more interesting to me.
People only notice when the power goes out, but our technologists and engineers are the ones that keep the power on and get it back on when the power's been out. So that's one of the places that they'd go behind the scenes, and any type of manufacturing process, from how paper is made to beers brewed, our technologists could have a hand in that. Before the students even graduate, usually we have a couple that already have jobs lined up. MB Power is one of the more well-known. They've hired a number of our former grads. Some of the JDI companies have also hired some of our former grads. A lot of the engineering firms throughout the province have hired a number of our grads. That probably accounts for 30% of our grads are hired by engineering firms, which do work for all those larger companies in a consulting basis.
Year 2 of electrical engineering technology provides more training in one of two possible pathways: power distribution, alternate energy. To learn more about electrical engineering technology, visit NBCC.ca.